games are something I like to look at every now and then. Because this is a very broad genre, I have divided the video in a non-scary bit and a scary bit. From the not-so-scary section, we have Venture to the Fell, a spooky 2.5D Metroidvania set in the strange town of Reningbrook, which has been overrun by a mysterious entity known as the Fell. Your goal here is to find your lost friend Ella, but we all probably know that she is down for the count somewhere. One of the cool things about this character is the awesome deer mask he always wears. Must be an insecurity problem. The stuff to look forward to the most in this game are the boss fights. From the looks of it, they will be very epic. If you want to touch some animals, you need to play Animal Well, a dark pixel art Metroidvania where you play as a thing hatched from a flower. As him, you venture through the haunting world of Animal Well. One of the great things in this game is that you can encounter a large amount of animals. Only because the animals are confined within small rooms, I can imagine the place reeks of dog farts. A game I wouldn't call horror but just dark is Senua's Saga Hellblade 2. A brutal action adventure Souls-like, which you can compare to God of War, especially with the Viking stuff. This game is second in an award-winning series, so I really recommend trying out the first game. Further, it's not really that special. It has good looks, it has amazing boss fights, and it just looks amazing. A game that will make you happier than the people from Smile is Flintlock: The Siege of Dawn. A dark action-adventure Souls-like where you play as an elite soldier from the Coalition Army. Your role is to venture, murder gods, and close the door of hell. The exploration aspect really jumps out in this game. It looks damn good. One thing you must be ready for is that your spotlight will be stolen as you travel together with a magical fox. The next game is edging a little bit more towards horror, but it's just not scary enough. Crow Country, a survival horror where you play as Mara Forrest. As her, you venture through a closed theme park trying to find the owner of the park, who has disappeared 2 years prior. If you only want to sightsee in this horror game, you can use the exploration mode where there are no enemies, thus you have no need for a gun. The map in the game oddly reminds me of Amnesia: The Bunker. The next game we have is Morbid Lords of Ire. A darker Souls-like that compares a bit to Elden Ring, Lies of P, Sekiro Shadows Die Twice, and many more. This game is a continuation and a reinvention of Morbid: The Seven Acolytes. So your goal here is to defeat the 5 Lords of Ire who have risen again. At least, I think that's what the goal is. The game doesn't really make it clear. But that doesn't really matter to me because from the trailer the looks of the game are amazing and the combat is very good. And according to Steam's description of the game, it has a unique sanity system. So that's good, but I have seen nothing about it. One of the likable things about this game are the weapons you can use in combat, especially the sickle weapons. It also has a greatsword which looks amazing to use, but I like them sickles more. Everybody likes a Disney movie sometimes, but if you combine Disney with horror, you get Bye Sweet Carol, a narrative horror game inspired by the greatest animation movies. In this game, you play as Carol Simmons. As her, you explore a dark rabbit hole. Basically, it's a dark version of Alice in Wonderland. If you love a passion project made by only one person, there's Shell of a King. A dark 2D bullet hell RPG that will push your dodging skills to the limit. Here your goal is to make your way out of the prison beneath the castle. The entire game is focused on boss fights, so I think you will see some amazing ones. One thing that was quite weird is that there is fishing. I never saw that in a game like this. Then we have a fun game to play with friends. Killer Clowns from Outer Space the game. A fun horror game to play with friends like Dead by Daylight or the late Friday the 13th. According to the developers, the game provides a unique approach to hide and seek gameplay. But in my mind, it's just a copy of Dead by Daylight with other abilities. So I look forward to seeing what the uniqueness of this game is. If you like stories and movies about the Monkey King, you should wishlist Black Myth: Wukong. an action RPG sourced like rooted in Chinese mythology. In this adventure you play as Wukong. As him you fight many amazing battles while seeing some amazing landscapes. This game is a take on The Journey to the West, one of the four major books in Chinese mythology. Then we go on to the scary section, but if you have any games you think should be mentioned there, drop it down in the comments. If you like to run around with your friends in the woods, don't do this where there are dangerous animals, use your Twitch list Together After Dark. A co-op physiological horror with a survival touch for up to 4 players. Here you are stuck in a forest and must try to find a way out. A good forest always makes a great environment for a horror game, just look at Slenderman. Being able to play it with friends will make it a bit less of a scary experience, but it will still be very dominant. Then we have a game that totally agrees that horror is a haunting experience. The Bridge Curse to the Extrication, a first person horror adventure where you need to survive in Wenha University, a place known for its horror stories. Here a group of 4 students is trying to make a horror movie to obtain more members of the film club. At night. Not the smartest thing to do at a location known for its horror. Then we have Paranormal Tales, a next-gen horror game based on found footage. The game has been popular for its use of found footage for its main gameplay mechanic. Here you play as people who have gone missing on footage. Quite scary. But this way you can relive what happened to them. Because there are a few people, you can experience various tales. It looks like a really scary adventure but still playable. Then we have Spectral Scream, a game that's not too hard to understand because it looks a lot like Phasmophobia. Your goal here is to retrieve the scattered cores of the purgatory to restore its stability. We also have Phasmophobia itself because this game has been in early access for years. But because we already know what this game is about, let's go on to the next. Surveillance is a pixel art spot the difference horror in which you have to prevent high paranormal activity. These anomalies can be in the form of missing objects, strange sounds, intruders from underworlds and much more. Then we have Reveal, a first person physiological horror filled with puzzles and adventures. Here you go into the past of Walter Thompson, as you get to see what role a circus plays in his brain. A circus always reminds me of Left 4 Dead 2, and that's also a horror, so this one is good. If you want to get stabbed by an English bloke, you should put an English Haunting on your wishlist. In this pixel art point and click horror adventure, you play as Professor Patrick Moore, who has 72 hours to prove the existence of the Great Beyond. Or else his metaphysics investigations department will be shut down forever. From the looks of it, I think you will definitely be able to prove it. On the exploration part, you can be satisfied with over 60 different amazing pixel art backgrounds. Have you ever been locked up in your own house? For many it's prison, for others it's a dream. This adventure is Luto, where you play as an individual unable to leave his own home due to the pain of losing a loved one. This is a beautiful game about the horror of the insecurity to the darkness that lurks behind anxiety and depression. The perfect game to make you crap your pants is Ill, a narrative-driven first-person survival horror game that transports you to a sinister settlement. You have the goal of uncovering the unsettling truth behind its descent into bloodthirsty madness. A game that lets you live through the horror of being a famous person is The Black Within, a single-player first-person physiological horror game where you play as a failed musician who sold their soul to the devil. Now you must live with the consequences. A pretty dumb decision if you ask me. One of my most anticipated horror games is the casting of Frank Stone, a physiological horror filled with lore. And if you're expecting Frankenstein, you're playing the wrong game. This character came from the makers of Dead by Daylight. Here you play as a group of friends discovering the untold story of Frank Stone's dark past. One of the cool things is that every decision you make in the game will change your fate. If you want to be a little bit more scared of water, you should wishlist Still Wakes the Deep. A physiological horror taking place on a collapsing oil rig in front of the coast of Scotland. So make sure you know how to swim when playing this game. This game is made by one of the makers of Amnesia and Machine for Pigs, Everybody's Gone to the Rapture and Dear Esther. A game you shouldn't make too much sound in is Panicore, a survival horror game that mixes permadeath, AI monsters and a co-op experience for up to 5 players. I'm a huge fan of the feature where you can see how much sound you're making. Monsters will not only hear your footsteps, but they will also hear you screaming your lungs out. Another horror game to play with friends is Ghostbane, a co-op horror game that can be played with 4 players. In this game you need to detect and catch ghosts that just have taken over the city, so I'm sure you can find something. Basically, this game is like your average co-op horror game like Phasmophobia, with unique equipment, unique ghosts and more. The game I'm looking the most forward to this entire year is Little Nightmares 3. A horror adventure that's known to be single player. But in the third game, for the first time you will be able to play co-op. Your friend or an AI will be able to play a character low or alone. With them you try to find a way that will lead you out of nowhere. I'm very interested to see what the story in this game is. There should be enough horror for now. If you want to see another game, click here. Thank you for watching, until next time.